Hello and welcome to the Albion Women's Show. I'm Dean Kilford.
I'm Verity Gallagher, and on today's show we have the goal scoring machine.
Ini Umotong in the studio. How are you doing?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good. Well, we just saw a selection of goals there that you've scored this season. Six so far?
Yes, that's right, six.
Although the club only credit you with five.
Yeah, I'm claiming that Oxford one.
Though. Yeah?
Yeah, that's it.
Thank you.
We're like definitely six, yeah. Definitely six.
But yeah, I was giving me a bit of banter for that. didn't really touch you, but it did touch me, so... My God.
I've been counting it. So I've
yeah. Thank you.
Six
thank
goals.
You.
I think you're then the leading goal scorer in both leagues, according to us anyway.
According to us.
Yeah.
And we're the official
adjudicators. Yeah. So congratulations.
Thank
great
you.
Start.
Do you, at this early stage, have a particular favourite?
Our favourite goal? I think it would be the Millwall game. Durham. Durham game. Yeah,
over the head.
Yeah, that was a brilliant goal.
Thanks.
Yeah.
So you've settled in well. It's been a... You know, I mean, you've scored goals wherever you've been. In fact, let's go back.
So you started off at Portsmouth.
Yep.
You broke the record. You're the leading goal scorer there in your first season, I think it was.
Yep.
And then 2015, that led you to get a call up, but we'll get back to that part later.
Yeah.
Just wherever you've gone, you've just broken records. 2016, you won the Golden Boot with Oxford. You were the leading goal scorer. How is it just, Dean was saying at the start, is it just ever since you started playing, have you just always just been scoring goals?
I mean, as a striker, it's always, you know, the aim and the goal to score as many as possible. But I think because I'm such naturally a competitive person, it's like, okay, like I will score, you know, like I will get the last touch or I will get the, you know, the goal. So I think that kind of stems from it. So,
And so you've been playing since you were 5 years old?
Yeah.
And so have you always played up front? Has it always been your thing? It's I want to score all the goals?
No, I mean, because I've always been quite tall. And when I first went to the Centre of Excellence at Birmingham, I've actually played in goal because of my height. And eventually they put me up top because there'll be no one in goal. I'll just be all the way up top, like, in getting goal, you know. I'll be there up front trying to score goals as a goalkeeper. So I think they eventually moved me to play as number nine. And it's just stuck ever since.
Happy days. Well, speaking of goals, you scored two more at the weekend. And I think we should probably show the highlights of that game against Tottenham right now. Coming into this game, started on the bench.
Yeah.
Was that a bit of a surprise?
Oh, no, not at all. I mean, we've had a really tough week. We had three games in 8 days. So I think the idea was, you know, just rest and rotate the team and just try and make us as fresh as possible.
Once again, going behind the early goal there and then this...
Oh, that's
opportunistic.
Job as number nine is to.
Yeah. You'd have gobbled that up as well. Yeah.
Right place at the right time. It was great work by Lucy.
Sophie Paris set up a second
again. So, half time coming into it, what was the message at coming into the break? 2-1 up. Obviously, similar positions in the league, same amount of points.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was just stressed the importance of this game and. How we need to just tighten up in our defensive. Yeah, that was my bit.
We really put out Danny Buret there.
Yeah. Celebrating on our own. Yeah, that actually winded me, completely knocked the wind out of me. And
then...
But you brought it back together there.
There it is, 4-1.
Didn't affect you for too long.
Yeah. No, I was up within a couple of minutes and I was back going again.
Brilliant stuff. How many minutes were you on the pitch?
I think about 15 minutes.
It's not bad, is it?
Yeah.
Is that because you were fresh?
Yeah, I was. I think Aileen said, oh yeah, we'll do all the hard work and I'll just come and I'll... So I was like, yeah, it works. So, no,
so you're going to aim to start on the bench every week now?
Well, I mean, whatever.
You're too competitive for that. Yeah, you won that starting position every week.
It was actually funny though because I was so eager to get on and the linesman was giving me a bit of a telling off because when I was subbed on, I ran the field, he's like, no, come back, you need to get your name and number and stuff. I told him my name and number and then I ran back on. And he was like, hang on a second, be patient. You have to wait for someone to come on before you can go back on. And I was like, oh, okay. So I was there, like, just waiting for Aileen to come on to the side and then I was like, winning them.
It didn't take long for you to make a difference and to find a silver score.
And settling it, what's it been like? All the players seems there's obviously a lot of new players in the squad, mm-hmm. yourself included, settling in. How's that been? The process seems to be quite smooth.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we have such... the dynamics of the team has been brilliant here, on and off the field. I think off the field, we have such a great relationship with all the girls, and you know, there's banter, there's jokes, but as soon as you step onto the field, whether it be training or a game, like, everyone's in the same frame of mind, everyone knows what they have to do, they're here for a job, and it's just such a great environment to work in and play in, and I couldn't be happier here.
So how did it then compare to your time at Oxford?
I mean, coming from Oxford, it was you know, it was a very much defensive game, and you know, being in a losing team to come into being in a, you know, in a winning team is a lot better, and I prefer it a lot more being an attacking player. So yeah, I definitely prefer it here.
Was it nice to score against them last Sunday?
Yeah, yeah, it was. I did score. No, it was really nice. Yeah, just the jokes and the banter from the girls has been brilliant, and I love it.
And being a young player, and there's quite a few experienced heads, is there anyone that sort of mentors or you sort of look up to in the squad?
Yeah, definitely. Danny Buett, she's my housemate, a good friend of mine now. And yeah, anything I have, you know, any concerns or worries, she's a great person to talk to. And she's just so down to earth and just so easy to talk to. And she's kind of taken the mother role of the team. And we actually call her the wise owl. but yeah, she's been grateful.
You and Fliss have quite a close relationship as well on the pitch.
Yeah.
We spoke to her a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
So if you're not scoring, you're setting it up, or vice versa.
Yeah, me and Fliss have, you know, we're always on the same page. You know, we talk about it in training, like, oh, okay, if I'm doing this, what, you know, what are you going to do? Or if you're doing this, I'm always going to do this. So it's, we kind of always know, you know, what each other's doing and where each other wants the ball and where wants to be. So, yeah, we have a great relationship on the field and off the field as well.
Brilliant stuff.
What was kind of your advice going into the games? Obviously, we'll get to Chelsea later on in the show, mm-hmm. but you did go from a defeat into such a great win there. What was kind of Hope's words to you as a team?
I think it was more importantly that, you know, each game that we play, we learn something. I mean, against Chelsea, it was that, you know, we are disciplined, we can defend, and we can barricade the best. And so it was just important that, you know, we take what we've learned and we, you know, we build on from that, you know. And each game, I feel like we set the bar a little bit higher, and every game that we go into, it's about getting to that bar and even, you know, going one step above. So, you know, from that, each game, we're just pushing that bar higher and higher, and, you know, we're learning and we're growing as a team. And I think that just showed on Sunday when we went out and we went from a loss.
And you, from a personal perspective now, we finished your studies, which we'll go on to very, very quickly. but are you focused fully on football right now?
Yeah, definitely. Football is my main priority, and I love it because, you know, when that can something that you love and your passion can be your main focus, it's a dream come true. So,
talking about dreams come true and also learning from games, you did get a call-up to the Nigerian international squad. It was in 2015?
Yeah.
You must have learnt a lot from there because you had camp, although you missed the first 2 weeks because of studies.
Yeah,
but you must have learnt a lot there then.
Oh, yeah, definitely. The World Cup especially, you know, it's our coaches drilled into us that obviously the importance of each game that we played, but also just translating that into training. So every training that we had, it was like it was a World Cup final, you know, and that intensity and that competitive spirit, you know, was drilled in even in training sessions. And that's something that I've taken and I've kind of taken with me wherever I've been. And I think the girls give me a bit of banter because sometimes, you know, I do kind of, I'm a bit too competitive and I, you know, I do kind of have late challenges and flying elbows and stuff. But so they forgive me, which shows like, what a great team I'm in, you know. So, but no, I've learned so much.
And that coming, so obviously, at a very young age, you came over from Nigeria, mm-hmm. but you obviously have close ties still to the country, family still out there?
Yeah, definitely. So all my immediate family is in England. We came when I was 1 year old, and but like the culture is still drilled into me. My mum's still there. She still cooks me loads of Nigerian food and packs it with me. My housemates have even tried a lot of that. But yeah, so I'm very much a dual nationality, Nigerian and British. Individual.
You got your first cap against Mali. Mm-hmm. It was a 1-1 draw. I guess your aspirations again is another call up.
Oh, definitely. My target is definitely set on, you know, being involved in the next next call up, and you know, just progressing as much as I can internationally as well as club level.
Well, the rate you're scoring goals, I mean, it's definitely well in sight.
Hopefully.
Well, sadly, that's all we've got time for in this first half, but we'll pick that up in the second half. We'll talk about the decision to play for Nigeria as well, because that's quite an interesting one, because I'm sure you could have options for playing for England as well. But you have been watching the Albion Women's Show. We'll join you for part two. Well, welcome back to the Albion Women's Show. And we're joined, of course, by the fabulous goal scoring machine, Ini Umotong. You seem to get embarrassed whenever we celebrate. You score goals. That's just a fair thing for us to say.
I guess I'm just not used to it, but...
just second nature.
We're talking before the break about international choice, and you chose to represent your motherland, I suppose. Is there any discussion or any regret for making that choice, and maybe not choosing, obviously Sandra Jewell necessarily not choosing England or one of the other British teams?
Obviously it was a big decision to make, and I spoke to my family, friends, coaches about the decision, but it felt right, and I love the style of play that the Nigerian team they have. It's a very attacking, very physical game, and I just felt that me as a player and my attributes, I just thought that it's the right team for me personally. So yeah, no regrets. And
that's good. So talking of international players, you did have a really busy week last week. You faced Chelsea on Wednesday.
Yes.
A lot of international players there in that team. How was it?
It was a great test for us, just to see where we compare with the best. And it was great. I mean, it was a hard game, a squad full of internationals, and then bringing on fresh internationals as well. But I think we did really well. We did great. So,
well, you were heavily involved in a lot of the positive play from the Albion, and we're going to show some of the highlights right now. Nice, that squad piece. So the very first challenge there, taken out. Now,
I thought that would have been a red.
So did I. And she got over a few more after that as well.
Yeah, no, we were fighting. We were right.
And there's that effort just right. And then such a good defensive position, then just at the back, switching off.
I mean, it was a great test, because even when they went on your team, your head, we didn't let our heads go down.
Literally all the highlights were breakaways.
You kept pushing forward. Yeah. You never just you never settled back.
Oh, yeah. I was unlucky not to push that past them.
And then you get a little move like that and the finish, and there's nothing you can do about
it. Yeah, what do you do about that?
What was going through your head at this moment?
Too many things. Too many things.
It was a good reaction save.
It was a great break.
I love your reaction there.
Like, I know I should have scored it. Yeah.
And then, I mean, put an unfortunate gloss on the end, putting that one in to make it 3-0. But as I said, when you look at a scoreline, black and white, and you think 3-0, you think, oh, they were hammered. Yeah. But the reality is, if you watch that game back, it was a good defensive discipline performance. And there were more than one or two chances to get in and score. So
yeah, I mean, 2-1, we'll say.
We can give you the goal against Oxford, but I don't think we can change the score.
You put on a really good display though. You closed them down, you held on to their attack, you didn't really let them break through as much. And like we saw, there were so many opportunities for you.
Yeah. I mean, we were great defensively. I mean, everyone was in the same frame of mind. Everyone knew that, obviously, we're going to need to defend for each other as well as ourselves in this game. And I think everyone knew that their work rate had to be right up there. So I think I can't fault the girls for that. I think we did great.
It was always going to be a struggle. They are the champions. They're the reigning champions.
Exactly. So we can't be too disheartened. But
now, after obviously the victory over Tottenham in the weekend, in a very good position, sort of between yourselves and Tottenham to get that second place and qualify. So that was a really vital win.
And that's why it was so important, especially because they'd just beaten Bristol and Yeovil. Yeah. So it was like, to us, in my mind, I was thinking, OK, we win this, we're through. We did that. So it's just Bristol we have left now on the 2nd of December. Assuming that Chelsea beat Tottenham, which they should, we just need to get a draw or win.
Do you feel like mentally you've now got one up on Tottenham?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Because in the league, it's ridiculously tight. 4 points separating top seven.
Yeah.
Is it an even league or is it just, it still needs to settle in?
Yeah, I think it's very early doors still. I think, teams are still settling. Everyone's still kind of scouting out how everyone is and, what they're like. And so I think, it's still very early doors, but I'm very, very confident.
It's a silently, theme.
Yeah. Silently, not so silently confident.
Recently, you've done a bit of work outside of football, which we want to talk about as well. A bit of charity work this week. But you seem to have been involved in quite a lot of projects outside of football. Mm-hmm. I've certainly noticed you loads of different things. I've just seen press gowns and you seem to always be one of the players there. Is that something that...
I have quite a bit of time on my hands, so I do always like to put myself forward to do bits and bobs outside of playing football, which I enjoy anyway, so it's always nice.
I'm sorry. You say you have time on your hands. You have just achieved a first-class honours from Southampton in economics.
She's achieved that.
It's crazy because, I say so much time on my hands because I've literally gone from whilst I was studying, playing full-time, to having no time whatsoever and just every second trying to make it count somewhere to here just twiddling my fingers like, oh, what to do. So, I consider this time on my hand.
Well, congratulations as well for that,
Thank you.
Brilliant achievement.
Thank you.
So do you advise all the players on their investments, what they should be doing?
No, not so much. It's funny though, because I have a couple of friends who are still in education now and they know that I have quite a bit of time. So they'll send me over some of their work. Oh, Ini, can you just look through this for me? And I'm like, okay, well, I don't have that much time in my hands.
Let's not get carried away.
Yeah, seriously.
Playing football here full-time.
I'm done.
I'm done with my stint.
And with the ambitions of the club going full-time, obviously that's the hope for next season. Are you already training in that mentality? Do you do extra sessions? How's it working?
Yeah, definitely. I think around the whole team, our mind frame is that we're going for WSL1. We should be WSL1. Training wise, when and where I can do extra work, I do, and it's the same all around. So yeah.
Speaking of extra work and competitiveness,
yeah,
it's time to bring us to the Brighton and Hove Buses Players Challenge. Now, the Players Challenge, most of the squad took part. And essentially, there's five balls placed around the pitch. And you got a point for scoring a goal. You get 3 points for hitting the crossbar. And let's see how Ini got on.
Ini Umotong, number 9, striker.
So, Ini, do you remember much about this?
I'm trying to pull it out of my mind for a tiny bit.
So, I'm netting to start. Yeah. A bit of my shaky camera work, I apologise. Point one. Not worrying about the extra points, just going in the back of the net.
That one was going for the crossbar.
You were unlucky on this one.
You're giving it away, Verity.
Hang on, did this not count?
It did count, yeah. Off the ball, you actually got a point.
They all count.
So 4 points. Let's see where that puts you on the leaderboard and joint seconds.
I'll take it.
Yeah, joint second. We're three people going. Joint second with 4 points.
I'll take it.
Obviously, Fern well out on top.
Completely put me to shame, didn't she? Defender.
Centre backs, they've got a point to prove.
They do.
um, that's a big common theme in the squad, is that competitiveness. Mm-hmm. And you speak about that as yourself. What goals have you got as a player? What do you want to achieve? And what can you achieve?
I want to be top goal scorer in the league.
That's it. What, yeah. Every year?
Every year.
Every year, everywhere. And obviously, we want to win the league. That takes priority, though. And we know that we should, and we can win this league. So that is definitely our priority and our main aim of this season.
And internationally?
Oh, yeah, to get my...
That one too.
Yeah, that one too.
Golden boot at the World Cup.
Yeah, and that too. I'll take that.
African nation, is there African nations? Maybe I'm being naive, but I don't...
Yeah,
there is some African nations, isn't there?
Next year.
Next year?
Yeah, next year. So, yeah, and obviously there's that as well.
What do you think you have to do for the call-up? Is it just a matter of really getting those goals?
Yeah.
What exactly is how you got the call-up?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, as a forward, you can only really, like, measure how well you're doing by the amount of goals that you're scoring and amount of assists that you're making as well. So it's just trying to get as many as I can and send them over to, Nigeria.
Well, did you see this one?
Yeah, look at me.
Wherever you can to help, we'll credit you with more and more goals, Ini. Yeah,
thank you.
Well, thank you very much for being on the show.
My pleasure.
It's been an absolute pleasure.
No, I really enjoyed doing this. It's been really
brilliant.
Fun.
Thank you.
This has been the Albion's Women's Show.